some Chiefs wide receivers that you can free your mind of.
Free your mind of.
Free your mind of Sky Moore. Free your mind of Kadarius Toney, of Justin Ross. It's okay to move on. I promise you, they're not going to produce. And if they do, come back and tell me I'm an idiot. After your rookie draft finishes, feels great because you got the players you wanted. But you're also almost always over the limit and you have to decide who to drop to the waiver wire, unless you're in one of those crazy deep bench type of leagues. But in today's video, we're going to give you the permission to drop certain players and other players. We might tell you, hey, you want to find a space for these guys. Do not let them off your team. Let's just start. And this is basically looking at the last year's class in 2023 with the obvious keeps. Okay.
Sure.
We're not going to spend too much time on this list, but anyone on this list, clearly you don't drop them, even if you're in a small league. All right. These dudes are staying on your team. A lot of them are helping you win championships this year. And some of them untapped potential. You just don't drop these names. All right.
Exactly.
That's obvious. But let's move on to the quarterback position and we'll go in order: quarterback, running back, wide receiver, tight end. And then at the very end of the video, we will even talk about names that are not in last year's class, but they're high power names. And we're going to give you the permission to drop them as well. And then you can blame us later if it doesn't work out. All right. So come back to this video and yell at us if it doesn't work out. Let's start with the quarterback position, Badaki. We're going to talk about players that are definite keeps, guys who are on the edge. And it depends on your league format, how big or small your league is. Mm-hmm. And then guys that we're dropping regardless of what your league looks like. So looking at the quarterbacks last year who aren't obvious ones, who are you definitely keeping?
I mean, I we have this huge list here, and I'm only keeping two. I don't know how you're feeling, but that's Will Levis and Aiden O'Connell.
I'm right there with you.
Those are the two guys I'm happy to keep. Obviously, Will Levis should be coming into a decent year. Same thing with Aiden O'Connell. Even if he loses that job to Gardner Minshew, does he somehow get onto the field this year?
Exactly. Like, is there really a way that Gardner Minshew doesn't play his way out of that role? Like,
exactly.
Potentially,
so, and then everyone else on this list, thank you so much for your service. There's nothing
so that I can straight see. Cut is what you're saying.
Yeah, straight cut.
Bye. So from Hendon Hooker all the way down to Max Duggan, who brought his team to a championship. Well, a championship game.
Quentin Johnson really brought the team to the championship. But whatever.
Did either of them bring either of them? I think they.
Or whatever.
Who knows? But straight cuts, just you're dead to me, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Yeah. I agree. I honestly do agree. Like, I wanted to make Hendon Hooker like an on-the-edge player. Like, maybe you could keep him. But at the end of the day, you and I have been very skeptical of Hendon Hooker since day one. This is a guy that we told people not to draft in rookie drafts simply because he wasn't better than Jared Goff. And Jared Goff was in a great situation, and we thought he's going to get a contract extension. Well, he does get a contract extension. Now the only reason to believe Hendon Hooker has any hope of being fantasy relevant is if Jared Goff goes down with an injury.
Exactly.
That's impossible to predict. So if you want to waste a roster spot instead of adding a guy who's undrafted or whatever, one of these rookies who are showing out in camp, and you just want to waste that roster spot instead of seeing what someone else could be, you go for it. But I agree. All these guys completely dead to me. Tyson Badgett's the backup in Chicago. I don't care. Sean Clifford's the backup in Green Bay. I don't care, right? No. Like, all these guys are gone. Stetson Bennett's the backup. I don't care. The guy's not a starter level.
He's not
even
with the team. Yeah, I mean, I don't know what's happening.
I think
there.
He is now, though. He is now. He's back.
Yeah. So, yeah, no thank you, and thank you for your service. We appreciate everything that you've done at the quarterback position, which is really nothing.
Yeah, exactly. Respectfully. Thank you for nothing. All right, let's move on to the running backs from last year.
Okay.
It's been a disappointing year for these guys. A lot of these guys landed in bad spots or didn't do what we wanted them to do. Mm-hmm. Let's start with names that we're definitely keeping.
Yeah. I have a couple names on this list here. And I'll start off here with Zach Charbonnet. I think you definitely have to keep, even if Kenneth Walker goes down. We keep saying if he goes down, top 12 running back, potentially Kendre Miller, that we kind of both are first seeing that he's going to have a good future. Big ol' Roscoe, I think you keep. Chase Brown downtown. Jalen McMillan, I think you should keep him.
Jahlil McLaughlin, maybe?
Jahlil McLaughlin, I think you should keep him. I put him in that keep category. Tank Bigsby, I still have him as keep because if he goes down, Travis Etienne, maybe another year under his belt, we can see something. And the last guy for me is Keaton Mitchell.
Yeah. I would agree. That's my list as well. Yeah. With Keaton Mitchell, I do think there's a chance that we quickly drop him in season.
Yes.
Keep agreed. In mind, he tore his ACL late in the year last year. He's not going to be ready for a while. And the fact that he was an undrafted free agent to begin with, there's very little, if any, evidence that he's going to be an important fantasy player. They also brought in Rasheen Ali, who's not the same player, but similar. Mm-hmm. And of course, they brought in Derrick Henry. But I agree with this list. I will say names like Rashawn Johnson, it feels almost like a task to keep them on your team. I don't know if they're ever fantasy relevant players. Same with Tank Bigsby. It feels like a task, but these are the type of handcuffs that you just can't let go of. So
yeah. Yeah.
I tend to agree with you there. Is there anyone you have on the edge of out of this list? Anyone that you're like, it depends on my team construction.
Yeah.
How big it is.
I have three people on the edge, three players on the edge here. And that's Eric Gray, because as much as I love Tyrone Tracy, he's only played the running back position for 1 year in Purdue.
Sure.
And if Devin Singletary gets injured and they don't believe Tyrone Tracy is ready, maybe it's Eric Gray. Now, is that exciting? Absolutely not. But right. there's a pathway there.
Last year, Jerome Ford probably wasn't exciting to roster, and you and I told everyone to roster him. So what's to say something can't happen, right?
Exactly. And if you don't have, let's say you have Devin Singletary and Eric Gray's on the waiver wires, why not go and pick him up just in case? Deuce Vaughn is somebody as well because of who the hell knows.
Starting slot wide receiver, Deuce Vaughn.
Starting
from
slot.
What we've heard out of camp.
Honestly, if he was 6 foot, he would have been the best running back out of college. But unfortunately, my guy's 5'6" or 5'5". But this situation is interesting, right? Obviously, yeah, Zeke is coming in. You have Rico Dowdle. What happens if, once again, Zeke wasn't even healthy the whole time last year? He was in and out of the games for the Patriots. Rico Dowdle, I know he can definitely come into a situation. But if not, how does he get utilized in this backfield? So I think it's worth keeping to understand how you see him or how we see him going into the season. And then the last guy, which may be a surprise, is Evan Hall.
I agree.
Evan Hall here. Zach Moss is no longer on this team. Jonathan Taylor has been struggling with injuries for the past couple years. If he goes down, what did Evan Hall do? He ran for a touchdown every single time at the NFL Combine. And I'm hoping and believing that can happen in a real game if Jonathan Taylor's not in. So
Do you know why I'm keeping Evan Hall? I mean, you just mentioned it, but I'm keeping Evan Hall because in the history of the NFL Combine, nobody has scored more rushing touchdowns. Nobody. So I'm absolutely keeping him on my team. There is a little bit of some concern, though, because we're hearing that Trey Sermon is the RB2 there. But
okay.
So you might be holding him
another year. No reason. Trey Sermon's up RB2 in the backfield. I mean, that's hilarious.
I don't think we've heard that. I think we've just heard that, like, yeah, he's good.
I think it was like, Elijah Mitchell, if he goes down, Trey Sermon's going to be the guy. He goes down, Trey Sermon gets hurt, like, on the first play. Same thing. If I'm not mistaken, it was the Eagles as well. They was like, it was him and Rashad Penny that was in conversation a couple years
ago. We have a really funny story about Trey Sermon in our home Dynasty League. Our friend Daniel Ilioy, shout out to Danny.
Mm-hmm.
He drafted him. He was really excited about him. And I was just opposing. I was just like, I don't think he's going to be, you know, this guy that you want him to be. And then he finally got on the field for the first time in a real NFL game. And the starter went down with an injury. And then Danny puts in the chat, it's Trey Sermon season, baby. And the first play, Trey Sermon gets knocked out, concussed, and he fumbles the ball. And the group chat just goes absolutely mental. So that is a fun memory. I'll talk about players that I'm cutting for sure.
Sure, yeah.
Let me free you of any burden of these names. They don't matter anymore. And that hurts to say, but Zach Evans, you're gone. Evans is done for. Israel Abanikanda, you're gone. Braylon Allen comes into New York. He's the clear RB2. For Zach Evans, they just drafted Blake Corum. You're not going to beat out Blake Corum if you couldn't even beat out Darrell Henderson last year.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Rodriguez Jr., Amari DiMarcado, they brought in, obviously, Trey Benson, Dwayne McBride. They brought in Aaron Jones, Lou Nichols, and Kenny McIntosh. These guys shouldn't be rostered in any league. I don't care how big your league is. It don't matter, okay?
Yeah.
Do you agree?
Yeah, completely agree. Nothing's going to happen there with those guys, unfortunately.
We're just about to get to the wide receivers, but we got to let you guys know that if you want to support the show here on Dynasty Land Football, consider becoming a Mother Flocker member with the promo code LAND.
Yeah.
If you do, you'll get a Dynasty team review on a live stream from Badaki and myself. You'll get our rankings. You'll get our draft guides for both rookie drafts and in-season fantasy football. You'll get a hotline where you can ask us for advice. All the tools and features on the website. Consider supporting. Check out the pinned comment. And let's get back to the wide receiver position. Let's move on to wide receivers. A very deep list from last year. And who are the obvious keeps for you? This is tough because I don't even know if any of these guys are ever actually going to contribute to fantasy starting lineups. Like any of the names, there's probably like four names that are worth
keeping.
I really think they're going to contribute.
Yeah.
But there's a lot that I'm like, I don't know if these guys ever even matter.
Yeah. I have a couple here players. Obviously it's Quentin Johnston. I'm happy to keep on my team. Also Jonathan Mingo. I'm happy to keep on my team just for one more year to see what that looks like. Marvin Mims, I'm also happy to keep as well. I mean, one of Sean Payton's first weapons that he drafted without having draft capital in last year's draft. And obviously they draft Troy Franklin in the fourth round. So that's very interesting. Jalin Hyatt, as much as we didn't love him coming out, there still could be potential opportunity, even though Malik Neighbor's going to be there. Can he be that deep ball threat? Can he be
Can I tell you why I struggle with him? Like, mm-hmm. I agree we should keep him. I struggle because, like, at best, he's a worse version of, like, Jameson Williams in Detroit.
Sure. I was thinking more like just a Gabe Davis boom game. Like, right, the best he can potentially do is have four receptions, but it's for, 150 yards because two of those catches were, like, 55-plus yards and more,
I think, right? I would sell him for, like, any pick in any draft, though.
Yeah, I can definitely see that there. Michael Wilson is somebody I'm happy to keep. I think he easily comes in as the wide receiver two in this offense. And what does that look like? I bought him as a stash player a couple weeks ago. Dontavion Wicks, I'm on the edge.
I'm on the edge, man.
I get it. Phenomenal talent. I just think Reed and Watson is still going to be the primary guys there. But I have him as a keep. If somebody,
he does everything that Christian Watson doesn't do well when it comes to actually like a functioning offense, consistently getting your offense down the field, over the middle of the field, operating in and out. He does everything that Watson doesn't do well. He's just not that same athlete. But I think Wicks, there's a chance he breaks out this year. I really think there is a chance.
I think, like, the only chance that happens is if Christian Watson
hurt. Where I disagree. I think Wicks earned playing time.
So he's going to surpass potentially over Watson this year.
I think it's not out of the question. I'm not saying it will happen. I'm saying it's not out of the question in my mind that he's a starting wide receiver for this team.
Okay.
He surpasses Dobbs and Watson.
Dobbs and Watson. Okay.
But I agree. Wicks is a stronghold. The only other names I'd add here is Tillman because he was just drafted. I know they brought in Jerry Jeudy. And then Pop Douglas and A.T. Perry.
Okay.
Got to keep those two names. A.T. Perry is stepping into a good role now. He might be a starting wide receiver in New Orleans. And Pop Douglas, as much as we love Polk, as much as we love Javon Baker, Pop could be the guy. That's not out of the question here with what we saw last year. So that's my only other keeps. Do you have another name you'd add here?
I don't have another keep. I have guys, and those guys that you mentioned were on the edge, like DeMario Douglas.
Really? I would rather keep Douglas and Perry than Jalin Hyatt, Marvin Mims, and Mingo.
Oh, really? I would rather keep those guys. And I think it's because of the capital. Okay. Third round draft capital for Hyatt, Mims, if I'm not mistaken, he was third round as well. And DeMario Douglas has two wide receivers that I think we can both agree are more talented than him. Now, is that solidified? No, because both those guys are rookies. Okay. But that's kind of where I'm at. A.T. Perry, I had as a, I'm happy for you to drop because I just don't believe in Derek Carr. I don't believe it. Sure. And I can't see it happening. And if it does happen, that's great.
Sure. I mean, Michael Thomas is gone. We saw A.T. Perry. He was pretty good last year in some small spurts. So mm-hmm. I'm willing to keep him. I think he's worth a keep more than like a Mingo is, honestly, more than a Hyatt. Yeah. Just being like,
Yeah.
More than a Tillman.
Yeah.
I honestly think Tillman is my least favorite hold of these names, but I'm only holding him where he was drafted last year.
I had Tillman as a drop because of the Jerry Jeudy, because of Amari Cooper. Honestly, because of Elijah Moore.
Sure. I guess that's fair. Let's put him on the edge then.
It's not exciting, but yeah, like, look, that's where he's at. And I have one last player that's on the edge for me, which I can talk myself to keeping him and I can talk myself to dropping him, and that's Trey Palmer.
Okay.
Jalen McMillan comes in on this team now. We saw what he did in the second half of the season. That's looked really exciting. He's really explosive, the way that they were really trying to get him involved as well. Can he continue to grow? But at the same time, that's really difficult now with Jalen McMillan, coming in and having that higher draft capital. Because I'm not mistaken, Palmer was a sixth-round capital. McMillan is a third-round capital. And can he easily surpass Trey Palmer? I think we can both agree, yes.
I just think McMillan's a superior talent, too. So
I get that.
He's on the edge. I would also put Parker Washington on the edge. Only reason is because I do think if Kirk doesn't get extended, there's a role for him. But that is like, you got to have a deep league to really stomach that. Otherwise, it might be time to move on. So players that are, I'm definitely cutting. I want to know if you disagree with any of these names. Trey Tucker, Kayshon Boutte, Ronnie Bell, Xavier Hutchinson, unfortunately.
Yep.
Andre Yoshivas and Charlie Jones, Tyler Scott, Darius Davis, Justin Shorter, Elijah Higgins, Xavier Gibson and Jake Bobo. Some fun names in there, but way down the depth chart, not going to make a difference.
Exactly.
All right. Rest in peace, moving on to tight ends. I think this is easy. Luke Musgrave, Tucker Kraft, and Luke Schoonmaker. Everyone else is cut.
Agreed. That I'm on the same page there. I don't have anything else to say.
Luke Schoonmaker is a tough hold, I'll be honest.
I think he could definitely be on the edge, but if Jake Ferguson goes down, instant opportunity. And we've seen that in the past where Dalton Schultz went down and then Jake Ferguson stepped up, right? And then if Jake Ferguson goes down, Luke Schoonmaker can easily step up there. So I like that.
Yeah, I tend to agree with you. All right, we're going to finish the video and we're going to talk about names that were not in the 2023 class. And I'm going to now free your mind.
Free your mind.
You can drop these players. And if it turns out to be a bad decision, come back to this video and yell at me, okay? You can drop Zach Wilson. It's okay. Mm-hmm. It's all right. In a super flex league, it's okay. Time to move on. It's been time to move on. You can drop Jimmy G. You can drop Miles Sanders. Yeah, he's got the contract. It doesn't matter. You can drop Miles Sanders. You can drop Sean Tucker, Michael Carter, Cam Akers. All right? You can drop, in my opinion, you can drop Tyler Boyd. I know a lot of people will disagree with this, and this might be the most controversial name on the list. I think you can drop him. With DeAndre Hopkins there, with Calvin Ridley there, if he couldn't produce in Cincinnati, how is he going to do it now with the worst quarterback? I don't know. I think it's time to move on. Okay. Rondale Moore, how about some Chiefs wide receivers that you can free your mind of? Free your mind of Sky Moore. Free your mind of Kadarius Toney, of Justin Ross. It's okay to move on. I promise you, they're not going to produce. And if they do, come back and tell me I'm an idiot. Okay?
Yep.
It's time to move on.
It's time.
You can let go of OBJ, David Bell, Zay Jones, Alec Pierce, and then this one hurts my heart, but Noah Gray. All right. Mm. No, Kelsey's not going anywhere. And no, Noah Gray is not going to replace him. Okay? It's time to move on. Do you disagree with any of these names? Because I know I made this list on my own.
No, I don't disagree. I do have two guys.
Okay.
That we can talk about really quickly.
Yep.
First guy, let's start off with the tight end position. Darren Waller. I think you can drop
him. Yeah, I agree. Great point. Move on.
Get him out. Thank you so much. Rap career could be potentially better.
No.
Couple but bangers out there.
Auto-tune stonks are way high now.
High. My guy cranked it up. And the last guy.
That was a tough watch. That was a really tough watch.
He's just going through something. He's going through a heartbreak, man. Give him some grace.
But call a friend. Don't release a song publicly and just call a friend and talk it out.
Call a friend. And the last guy, which I know you're not going to like.
I know who it is.
Treylon Burks.
Sure.
When the head coach says, my guy has to gain a role. I'm trying to think of the word. Prove himself, essentially, on this team. We're going to start him with special teams first. He's at the dirt. He's at the bottom right now.
Sure.
And my guy has to work his way. Our first round pick has to work his way up to get some playing opportunity, starting from special teams.
I get it. In most leagues, you probably should drop him. In my leagues, I want to show my players that I believe in them, so he'll stay on my bench.
I would rather keep
because when I win championships, I want them to know that every single part of the team matters. You know, in Formula One, that where they say, shout out to the factory, you know, putting in all the hard work. When I win my championships, I'm going to say, shout out to Treylon Burks, talking the guys up in the locker room.
Team support.
He is really the heart and soul of the team.
Team support.
I can't let him go. He is vital team support.
I would, and you said somebody, it was just Tyler Boyd. I would actually keep Tyler Boyd over Treylon Burks. If you had Treylon Burks or Tyler Boyd on your team right now, because of Callahan coming from the Bengals, I would rather have Tyler Boyd.
Yeah.
That's what
I'd rather have a fourth round pick than either of those names now. But
agreed.
I get it. Look, that's it for today, guys. We appreciate you. Do us a favor. Hit that like button to show some love. Subscribe if you like the content. And we will see you guys very soon. All love. Now that those idiots are done talking, who needs some rankings?
Hell yeah, I need some rankings.
Then use promo code LAND, L-A-N-D, for 30% off any membership at flockfantasy.com.
Oh.
It's so easy. Even your grandma could scan that QR code right there.